Hi everyone, I'm Dishan. I'll be presenting our work on hardness of approximation of the Euclidean K-median problem. And this is a joint work with Professor Anup Bhattacharya and Professor Rakesh Jaiswal. So first, let me start with the definition of the K-median problem. In the K-median problem, we are given a set of clients in a d-dimensional Euclidean space. And our goal is to find a set of K facilities in the same Euclidean space, such that the sum of the transportation cost of all the clients to their closest facility is minimized. This transportation cost is given by the following objective function. In this objective function, we simply take the sum of the Euclidean distances of every client to their closest facility. Here, f of x denote the facility location that is closest from x. And this is how we define the k-median problem. A very related cost function to the k-median problem is the k-means cost function, in which we simply take the square distances instead of normal distances. And this also gives the clustering of the entire dataset. So now let us discuss what are the results that we already know about this k-median and k-means problem. Note that there are three parameters to the problem, n, which basically is the number of the clients, k, which is the amount of facilities that we want to open, and d, which is the dimension of the Euclidean space. Based on these parameters, various results are known for the k-median and k-means problem. For example, when k is fixed, means when k is constant, then petas is known for both these problems. And when d is fixed, again the petas is known for both these problems. And in the general case, when neither k and d are assumed to be fixed, then a constant approximation is known for the k-median problem, which is 2.633. And a 6.3 approximation is known for the k-means problem. Now the question is, can we obtain a petas for k-median and k-means problem in the general case? In 2015, it was shown that the k-means problem is hard to approximate within some constant factor. And this factor has been recently improved to 1.07. However, no such result is known for the k-median problem. And this is because the one median cost is difficult to analyze. So let us elaborate on it a bit more. Suppose we are given a set of clients and we want to compute its optimal one means. Then, in other words, we want to open a facility which minimizes the sum of square distances from every client. And we can show that this optimal one means will be located at the centroid of this client set. However, such a result is not known for the one median problem. In other words, if we are given a client set and we want to open a facility location that minimizes the sum of the Euclidean distances to every other client, then we do not know any closed form expression for the optimal one median. And this problem is famously known as the Fermat-Weber problem. And despite these difficulties, in this work, we show hardness of approximation for the k-median problem. And this closes the open problem. So now let us look at the hardness of approximation of the Euclidean k-median problem. We will show a reduction from the vertex cover problem to the k-median problem. And for the vertex cover problem, it is known that assuming unique schemes conjecture, the problem cannot be approximated to any factor smaller than 2. And this result holds for the bounded degree triangle-free graphs. Equivalently, we can say that it is hard to distinguish between the instances which have vertex cover smaller than k and the instances which have vertex cover greater than 2 minus epsilon times of k. So let us now describe the reduction from the vertex cover problem to the k-median problem. Suppose we are given this graph instance g with vertex set v and the edge set e. Then what we are going to do is that we are going to map every edge of this graph to a point in a v-dimensional Euclidean space. The position of this point is defined in the following way. If this edge is incident on two vertices I and j, then the ith and jth coordinate of that point is going to be 1 and the rest of the coordinates are going to be 0. In this way, we map every edge of the graph to a point in a v-dimensional Euclidean space. And using it, we show that if the vertex cover of the graph is less than k, then the optimal k-median cost of the instance is at most m minus k by 2. And if the vertex cover of the graph is large, that is greater than 2 minus epsilon times of the k, then the optimal k-median cost of the instance would also be large, that is, it is greater than m minus k by 2 plus delta k. Here, m denotes the number of edges in the graph, and it is known that in the bounded degree graph, the k and m are linearly related. Therefore, the term m minus k by 2 plus delta k can be rewritten as 1 plus epsilon times of m minus k by 2. And this is how we get a constant factor gap between the yes instances and the no instances. And this gives a 1 plus epsilon hardness of approximation for the Euclidean K-median problem. So now let us prove the first property, that is, if the vertex cover of the graph is less than k, then the optimal k-median cost of the instance will be less than m minus k by 2. So now consider this graph instance, which has a vertex cover of size k. And let us consider two of its edges, which are incident on the same vertex. Now let us compute the distance between these two edges. So these two edges will be mapped to two points in a v-dimensional Euclidean space. And the coordinates of these points is going to be in this way, that at one of these positions, both are going to be 1, and the other two positions, they are going to be different. As you can see, the distance between these two points is square root 2. In the same way, we can show that if there are two edges which are vertex disjoint, then the distance between the points is going to be 2. Therefore, it is natural to group the edges which are incident on the same vertex. And this is how we are going to define the K-clusters. Here, the red edges which are incident on the first vertex will be clustered into the first cluster. The blue edges are going to be part of the second cluster, and the green edges are going to be the part of the third cluster. And this is how we get the K-clusters. And now we want to bound the optimal K-median cost of all these clusters. Now look at the cluster 1. All these red edges form a regular simplex of side length square root 2. Since a regular simplex is a symmetric figure, it can be shown that the optimal 1 median is located at the centroid, and using it, we can exactly compute the 1 median cost of the cluster 1, and it comes out to be square root m1 into m1 minus 1. Here, m1 is the number of edges in the cluster 1. Similarly, we can obtain the optimal cost of cluster 2, and henceforth, all the clusters, we can obtain the optimal cost. And the total cost will be given by the sum of these costs, and it can be shown that it is smaller than m minus k by 2. This completes the proof of the property 1. Now let us move to the property 2, in which if the vertex cover of the graph is larger than 2 minus epsilon times of the k, then we wanted to show that the optimal k median cost of the instance is at least m minus k by 2 plus delta k. And here we are going to prove the contrapositive statement, that is, if the optimal cost of the k median instance is less than m minus k by 2 plus delta k, then the vertex cover will be small, that is, it's going to be less than 2 minus epsilon times of the k. Suppose the optimal clusters are c1 to ck. Now, some of these clusters are going to be star clusters, and some of these clusters are going to be non-star clusters. Note that for a star cluster, the size of the vertex cover is exactly 1, and the optimal cost is exactly square root m1 into m1 minus 1, and this cost can be approximated as m1 minus half. However, for a non-star cluster, obtaining the bounds on the vertex cover and the optimal cost is a non-trivial task. However, it is immediately follows that the vertex cover of a non-star graph is at least 2, and the optimal cost is going to be at least m1 minus half plus some extra cost. And we can also prove this fact formally. Also note that the total optimal cost is at most m minus k by 2 plus delta k. It means that the total extra cost over all the clusters is going to be at most delta k. Now for the non-star clusters, we will obtain a non-trivial bound on the size of the vertex cover and the optimal cost. Now consider this non-star cluster. We will first find a maximum matching of this non-star cluster. Suppose this maximum matching has L edges and the remaining edges of the graph are T. Then note that all these red edges are at a distance of 2 from each other. It means they form a simplex of side length 2. And for a simplex, we know that the optimal 1 median is located at the centroid of the simplex. And hence, we get the following optimal cost for the red edges. So the optimal cost of the red edges is this much. Now we want the optimal cost of the remaining edges. Note that the optimal cost of the remaining edges would be at least the cost of the star graph, because the star graph has the most compact representation. So the optimal cost of the non-star cluster would be at least the sum of these two quantities, and this quantity can be simplified as follows. Note that the first term here is the cost of a star graph with m1 edges, and the second term is basically the extra cost of this non-star graph, and hence we obtain a stronger bound on the extra cost of this non-star graph. Now let us look at the bound on the size of the vertex cover, and it is fairly easy. The vertex cover size is always 2 times of the size of the maximum matching. Note that the optimal cost is lower bounded in terms of L, and the vertex cover is upper bounded in terms of L. Using it, we get the following relation between the vertex cover and the extra cost of non-star graph. That is, the vertex cover of non-star cluster is at most 6 times of its extra cost plus 6. And recall that the total extra cost over all the clusters was at most delta k. It means that the total size of the vertex cover can be now bounded as 6 times of delta k plus 6k. This is the bound on the vertex cover of the entire graph, and for appropriately small delta, we can rewrite this term as 6k plus epsilon k. By doing a more finer analysis of the size of the vertex cover and the optimal cost of the non-star cluster, we can obtain a better bound of less than 2 minus epsilon times of k. And this completes the proof of the property 2, and thus we obtain 1 plus epsilon hardness or approximation for the k-median problem. So we cannot obtain the pitas for the k-median and k-means problem. So the next natural question is, can we obtain the pitas by giving some flexibility to the algorithm? In other words, can we obtain the pitas by opening some extra facilities? And such type of algorithms are known as the bicriteria approximation algorithms. And the question is, can we obtain pitas with such flexibility? In this work, we show that even with such a flexibility, pitas is not possible. That we show that with 1.015k centers, the k-median problem is still hard to approximate within some constant factor. And the k-means problem is hard to approximate even with 1.28k centers. Previous techniques can be easily extended to prove these two results. Note that all our results assumes unique Skeams conjecture, and recently all these results have been improved by Vincent Cohen et al., Karthik CS, and Yuwong Lee. They show improved hardness of approximation results for the Euclidean k-median and k-means problem, assuming p is not equal to np, which is a weaker assumption than the unique Skeams conjecture. Thank you.